And now to our honored speaker. We're so pleased to have with us tonight Dr. Phuntsog, Wangmo, the International Director of the Shang Shung School of Tibetan Medicine here in Conway, in the old grammar school up in the hill, as many of you know. Dr. Wangmo received her training at the Tibetan Medical University in Lhasa and started and ran the Tibetan Medicine Clinic in, Tibetan Medicine Clinic in rural Tibet before going on to teach Tibetan medicine all over the world, including here in Conway. We're very fortunate to have her with us tonight to tell us about the history and practice of this ancient healing system. So without further ado, Dr. Wangmo, thank you so much.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And I'm very honored to be here tonight with you. So, as the other lady said, I was, I did not grow here in this country, and in particular in Conway. But I lived here almost now 16 years, since 2001. It's very, interesting story. I grew up in Tibet. I was born in Tibet. I grew up in Tibet. Tibet is ideally middle of the snow, therefore it's roof of the world or top of the world or whatever. As if I say I came from Tibet, then people think, oh, you need a heavy coat for sure, because it is Tibet. But then I came across, thousand miles. Again, arrived in the middle of the snow. You see, this is my karma, so once I feel it from there. Then we opened another one school in Russia. Again, I crossed thousand miles. Again, arrived in the middle of the snow. So, came from snow, land of the snow, and arrived in sort of like land of the snow. So that I think this is my karma, so I like, really, I love this country and especially this region, so I felt that Conway is my hometown. So today is to be here and to meet all of you is really is very honored. And as the gentleman mentioned, in the, this the old Conway school, we've been there years and years. And for us, it's really important to knowing or to meeting with the neighbors. In the Tibet, we have a like joke. We say is the neighbor enemy is much better than far distance relatives. Because Tibet is, we don't have emergency cars and emergency phone calls. Everything is depend with the community. Everything is resolved within the community. We help each other. So. It's normally we sort of like neighbor fighting, but then something happened, emergency is first hand, is that your neighbor. So then that what we say is that the neighbor enemy is much better than far distance relatives. So for us, it's neighbor is very important. So thank you, and then it's great. So the Tibetan medicine, tonight is our topic is the Tibetan medicine. So the Tibetan medicine is, many people thinking that Tibetan medicine must be similar with Ayurvedic, because it's this one of the major neighbor country, and especially is Buddhism teaching is introduced from India. So they think Tibetan medicine must be rooted from Ayurvedic. And then the another group of people thinking is that the Tibetan medicine must be rooted from the traditional Chinese medicine, because that is that where we end up. So this is also one of the, our larger neighbor countries. Put it mildly.
So, what I want to say is that Tibetan medicine is rooted from Tibet and then land of the snow or just the yeah. So, we Tibetan medicine, we have everything is set up, established like today, like everything like this, that our main textbook is completed now is over 2,500 years. Mm-hmm. And then before that also the Tibetan medicine is practiced in the village, in the community. So that before the Buddhism introduced to Tibet, we have our own religion, which called the pre-Buddhism. And then later, then the Buddhism introduced to Tibet. So today, in our religion is mainly is the Buddhism, and then also we have other parts of the practice. So the Tibetan medicine is since Tibetan medicine is very ancient, one of the healing system. Our healing system is not only like today, like today a new medicine, only sort of like the body study or the chemical studies. Tibetan medicine is what we try to understanding is that the outer nature and the inner body is they integrated. So there are certain mechanisms sharing. An example is outer season is changing, inner body also affecting. So that also we know, we have the experience. And then same thing also is that the morning and then evening is the 24 hours of the cycle of the time, also our body is changing. For this reason is sometimes we need to wear more clothes, sometimes we don't need to wear the clothes, sometimes we have little short temper and sometimes we are a little more happy, so on and so forth. Who's making all those sort of like interesting characteristic or the changing, because is that the outer nature is changing, the inner body is changing. So when we're looking this kind of thing, I think we handled it. So the one is that the Tibetan base of the Tibetan medicine or the foundations of the Tibetan medicine is we talking the five element. So we believe is the five element is the like a phenomenal or the foundation of all the existing things. So when we're looking like in our body, we have like the heavy structures like bone, muscles, and then we have like liquid, like all the fluid. And then we have also like the subtle, like a little deeper, we have all the organs. So those are the visible things. But also then we have certain is invisible, but we can feel. And then we have another one is, it could be they existed somehow, but is even we could not feel. So this kind of like, when we're looking like the rough element, medium element, and then more fine element, subtle element. So for this reason also we have this earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, and space element. So like the water, earth, those kind of is we can touch, we can feel, we can see. But as when we get into the fire element, those kind of not like are structured by the form, like a material. So we cannot touch, and also the wind element, but we can feel. But when we get into the space level element, even we cannot feel, but it existed. An example, sometimes we say it's like a provocation. So this kind of is, even we don't know where's provocation, who's provocation, how they attacked, but it is somehow we feel. So we have this, the theory or idea. So the certain we have idea, but if there's no concrete, either it's touching or feeling. So those five elements is that we believe all the like this world, either external world or internal sentient being, everything is made out of, or the formed out of this, the five elements. So the five elements are the earth, water, fire, wind, and space. So those are the five elements. So based on this, the five element theory, and then we have how important is the environment with our sentient beings. How important other sentient beings with the human beings. Because it's like this world, like Earth, as like the house hosting all those beings, including us. We are the human being, one of the who's living in this motherland or this earth, but we are not unique being in living in this planet. There are also many other animals or other beings. They're also living. And then, but of course, among those sentient beings, and especially the Tibetan Buddhism idea, is that the human being is one of the special beings among those sentient beings. Why is the human is a special being? Because we have capacity or the talent to show expressing our feeling. If I don't like, I can say to you I don't like, or I can show the face which I don't like, or I can show you the certain symbolic which is I don't like. But the other sentient being is not able to do that, many of them. Same also when I'm happy human, and then we have many level, many way we can expressing how I'm happy like. So this kind of is the one of the human quality. And the same thing also we can feel or we can understand other people's or other sentient beings softly. So through that, the hearing or understanding or hearing or seeing the other beings suffering, we able to understand that, so like apply to our own body, so we can understand how that would be. So then we have this that compassion or the patient, or we sort of willing to help or willing to do things. And then not only that, also we have sort of like capacity to choose or to choice what would be the good for our life. So when we're looking like the happy, everybody like happy, you know? Mm. There's one great master of the Sakya tradition in the Tibetan Buddhism. He said is that the horse is running towards the happiness. The little ants, the small ants also running towards the happiness. And then human also running to the happiness. So all the sentient being is running up and down and up and down, keep all times busy. What is searching is happiness. So where is that happiness? So happiness is that the one of the all sentient beings' goal, but the only human sort of there has a fully capacity to choose that. So when we look at the happiness, there is different people, different way of the pursuing or understanding their happiness. Some people, it's like they help to the other beings. Once they see the result, other people's happy and they feel happy. And some people is just, I want to be happy, so, and then other, I want to close the window. So there's many different way they're pursuing their happiness, but is anyway, it doesn't matter how they're looking, but as they try to find the happiness. So this kind of way is the among those sentient beings, we believe is the human has a certain sort of like capacity. So then that way they call is Joshok, so the human is the one of the supreme being in the planet. So since this the human is a supreme being, but then the duty of the human is that once we feel this, that the special, and then try to help to the other sentient being, try to make happy, healthy, whatever, try to relieve their suffering. So this kind of reason, since the human being is to get the human life, is this is difficult. Once we get the human life, there is a multi obstacles to taking the life. So we know many children dies before get out of the mother's womb. Many children dies as soon after get out of the mother's womb. And then many people dies in the youth and then the middle age, so on and so forth. So to keep like the senior age is not easy. Is to get the senior age is that the Tibetan point of view is really lucky because you made till that point. So that means you had a good karma, you had a very sort of like a past karma, you had a very good past karma, so this life is you able to make that. But then many people were not able to do this kind of thing. So human is very special, but there's a multi obstacles. For that reason is that each tradition, each culture, they have a how we can keep the human life a little longer. And then meantime is more healthy. And the meantime is not only the physical body, but also the inner body, like the energy body or the mental body. So what they say is body, mind, speech, no? So how we can keep the healthy. So for this reason, each tradition, they have the medicine. And then our Tibetan medicine is, as you mentioned before, is based on this, the five elements. So through this, the five elements, now we try to make understanding how integrate, how we should integrate to the outer nature, and how we should respect that outer nature, and then also inner being. So this, the five element, the body of the five element, and there's certain is we able to reach, certain is not able to reach, but we can feel this element. To maintain this element is we need to supply the outer element, and then to maintain the inner element. So that is what we eating food, and then 30 times a day we need to eat food, and then a couple of times we need to drink the liquid. So those are the, we are supplying the outer element to the inner element. So try to maintain the inner element. So of course we all know how important to eat food, because that is that we grow up with the food. And then also another one important for the maintained our inner element is the breathing. So the breathing is another one is able to inhale or able to supply the subtle five element into the body. As I mentioned before, there is a rough element, more fine subtle element, and a more subtle element. So the rough element we can eat through our mouth and then digesting through all the digestive system process, and then we're able to regenerate the our existed element. And then the more subtle element, and then we're breathing, through the breathing, then we're regenerating our subtle level of the five element. And then there's another more subtle element things, then it goes with our mental. So today also the allopathic medicine also, they say if you get too much stress or anger, that also get the complicated disease. So this kind of, so the Tibetan medicine we say is that your mind is one of the very important to keep the health or unhealth or happy or unhappy or whatever. Not only the physical bodies when they're happy. So the physical body, when we're talking this, that the five element made the, our body, like that earth element. Earth means is heavy. Earth means is stable. Earth means is concreted. Earth means is that something that is structured. So in our body, what are the earth element in the physical body level? All our like the concrete materials are the earth element. So this, that the concrete earth element keeps our body as like stable. So we able to move, is not falling down.
we're able to sort of like sitting or we're able to do things is that the stable or formed thing is the giving the earth element. What the earth element is do for our mental aspect, all the calmness, all the sort of like thinking. So once we think, once we get one idea, we judging that idea is good or bad or should apply or should not apply. So this kind of all those capacity, they're coming from that earth element. So earth is really important one. At the same, that the water element is all our body fluids, all the smooth, fresh. So those is that the water element. So the water element is to keep the, our body is like smooth, and to keep the, our body is like prevent from the. There's a lot of they do, but it's one of the rough part is like the, to keep the smooth and then to circulate things. The body like that not dry the function. Like an example, when we want to move the joint need a lubrication. Without a lubrication, then what we call is rheumatoiditis. So then we get the problem. Too much lubrication, we get arthritis, which also is not the happy part. So this kind of this the liquid, whatever this element is, it serves our body. And the mental part is the water element is basically same with the earth element. Then we have this the fire element. What the fire element do correspond in our body, all the heat, all the temperatures, all able to like digesting things. Everything like to make it mature. So everything is the function of the fire element. Included our like sharpness, mind, or the vision, or the, all the sense organs. Also like the mature, sharp, all those is like the, came from the fire element. Then we have the wind element. So wind element in our body, what they do is it, all the circulation is that the wind element, they move. Like we said is that the, all the channels are the, like the road. Wind is like the vehicle, and then the fluid or the whatever they need to circulate like a blood lymph. So those kind of are like the passengers. So that means is that the everything is like the connected. And then the special, the wind element for the mental aspect, all the thinking, thoughts, all those sort of like the creating idea is the loom, the wind element. And the space element is gives more room to develop all of them. So this way is that the roughly five elements supporting each other, relies each other, and then to keep the healthy the body. So once we want to restrain this, the, our five element body or the regenerating the five element body, then as I said before, we eating food. So the, when we eat food also within the five element, there's nothing beyond the five element. So the five element food is how we can identify, oh, this is earth element, oh, this is water element, oh, this is more so like fire element. Through the taste, we able to identify which element is more predominated in this food. An example, when we're looking like the sweet taste, all the sweet taste is predominated by the earth and the water element. That does not mean is the other element is not participate or not involved, no, but is the earth and water element is more predominated. And then when we're looking like the sour taste, so the sour taste is more like the predominated by the fire and earth element. And then when we look in the salty taste, and the salty one is that the more predominated by the water and the fire element. When we're looking that the bitter taste is more predominated by the
wind and then water element. Then we have like the spicy, like the hot, like chili taste, the hot taste. So the hot taste is predominated by the wind and the fire element. And then we have the astringent taste, last taste. So astringent taste is one of the Tibetan medicine, like it's special compared with other neighbor medicine. The astringent taste is predominated by the earth and the wind element. So we say so this six taste is composed by the two element is more predominated way. So when we looking like what are they the sweet taste? All the dairy product is sweet taste. All the meat product is the sweet taste. Wheat product, most like grains, are the sweet taste. Like rice, barley, those like. So that way also today we say you should not eat potatoes, or there's a lot of like a diet. People don't eat wheat product. Because it's a wheat product is a sweet group of the sweet. Sweet is earth and the water element. So that makes you is more heavy. Because it's earth and the water element. So if you eat more earth and the water element and then they produce more earth and water element in your body, so that also is not that good things we are looking for. But then, how about we don't eat the water and the earth, the sweet taste, because the sweet is earth and the water element, making you is gain weight or so on and so forth. Also, it's not good because the earth element is one of the main keep us stable. So that also is not good. So for this reason is that every taste, all those the six taste is to eat like the a proper way. So this is that the one. And then also when we looking the when we looking like the food, an example groups of the sweet like the grain group. Commonly what we have like a barley, wheat and the rice. When we're looking like this tray, all this tray is like the taste is sweet, earth and the water element. But the origin where they grow is a slightly different nature. Like wheat is cultivated in the late autumn or winter underground, and the spring comes, so it's more heavy because it's more cooler and a more heavy nature. The barley can be grown everywhere, but special is barley grows in the high elevation of the land. It's more dry, so it's not bad as like heavy as like other sweet. The rice is, we know where they, how they cultivating the rice. Now rice is we need to cultivate in the middle of the muddy, in the water, but is a hot climate and does not grow like in Tibet, like a cold climate, it does not grow. For this reason, like the rice is like more neutral. So when we're looking like these three grains, barley, wheat, and the rice, barley is warmer, wheat is cooler, heavier, and the rice is more neutral. Same also when we're looking those the meat group, all the meat is sweet. But also that depends on which animal. Like chicken, like a bird which has a wing is a lighter because they're able to fly. And then like a pork, what you call the pig, those kind of little heavier because as we know the pig, you know how it looks like. And then the other, like the water animal, this kind of is more warmer, lighter because is their how they living style. So this kind of even is that the same, like the domestic animal, or the same that the meat group, but is the based on the how they, the lifestyle, how it looks like, and then the nature is slightly different. For this reason, when we're talking the Tibetan medicine, diet. So we don't have a universal diet. We do have a diet is very large and deep diet, but is our diet is not good for everybody. Our diet is individual diet. And the same also the Tibetan medicine, when we get into the treatment, is individual treatment, not like some one medicine good for everybody, not like this kind of thing. So far what I'm saying is that the Tibetan medicine history, like a brief history of the Tibetan medicine is came from the Tibet before the Buddhism. The pre-Buddhism time, the Tibetan medicine is in Tibet. And then later there are some update or the new information came from the neighbors. We adopted the new information from the neighbor countries, but the root of the Tibetan medicine is came from the Tibet. The theory of the Tibetan medicine is that they're based on the five elements. Through the knowledge of the five elements, we able to understand how important outer nature and how important inner nature. Among the inner nature means is all the sentient beings. Among those sentient beings, inside this sentient being also how important to respect and then to respect each other and how important to survive together. Why? Because we all sharing one earth. We try to conquer another one and we win, there's nothing to win because we need to stay in that planet. If we lose also, there's no place to go. We have to stay in this planet. So this kind of idea, so how important this outer nature. And then also when we're looking at our body, if we're talking like terms of we're talking that to keep, maintain our health, how important to observing that the seasonal changing. How important observing that the 24 hours of the cycle. So looking, observing those things and a certain hour, certain season, we eat certain food and we act in certain way. So this is the general way of to keep the Tibetan, basic Tibetan medicine idea. So far it's clear? Okay, so this one is, since we don't have so many time, so I will try to, this is part of our basic idea of the Tibetan medicine, how that works. So now I try to go, second part I try to go is that the how our mind and the body is how we can integrate, and how that the mind conflict to the body and the body conflict to the mind, because these two is always need to be together, and the one bossing the other one. So and then if the boss too strong, and then the people don't like. If the people too lazy, the boss is not happy. So we see what the Tibetan medicine, that idea about this part. So when we're looking at our mind, so when we're looking at the cause of the disease, so every disease, as we said before, the five element is balance, time is we are healthy. They are supporting each other and they need to maintain the body. So, but it's still we have eating, we need to eat and then we need to act and then we need to think and then so there's a multi-problem conflict to our five elements not able to maintain. So one of them is that when we look at why they're not able to maintain, and always there is a cause and the condition. So there is a, always says condition. So when we're looking at the cause of the disease, there is a long distance course and a short distance course. So the long distance course is that we call the three poison. So the three poison is hatred, attachment, hatred, and ignorance. So these three is, we say, is the three poison. So that does not mean is a poison, so we will die immediately, no, because we are living with these three poison. We are functioning with these three poison. Why we say is a poison is that to giving it a warning signs, say is like when we go some places, the warning signs are right in the light, you know, like red light, you know, that is sort of like the sometimes like shining light. So these kind of warning signs. Why they saying, okay, you are living with these three characteristics of the energy. If you do not pay attention, sooner or later, they will harm either you or the other people. So that is that way they call is the poison. So also there's a great Indian master, they call the Nagarjuna, maybe you know. The Shantideva, he said is the temple launching your but the shishin the tam takte. So this our mind is looks like the crazy elephant. So we need to always make sure it's tight. So if we have a crazy elephant with us, we need to pay attention, does not run into the people, no? Otherwise they can make problems. Even is that the physical element, the elephant runs into the body, I mean into the people, they can damage or kill the people, but it's something we can count. But our mind cranies, this that the crazy elephant of our mind goes to the wrong direction, they do is countless problems. That we see today, you know, there's a lot of news comes every day, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, all those problems, who's making is the mind, you know? They're normally making this mind. I mean, the problems. The problem created from the mind, you know? One thing, I'm better. The other one thinks, oh, no, I'm better than you. So then this kind of way, then we conflict, and then since the beginning till now, so even we don't know when we end in this problem, but... So this one we call the three poison. So the attachment, hatred, so this kind of. So if you have a strong attachment to someone or something, also in the logically, the first thing is when we sort of attach to something, we really want it, you know. And the first thing, we're not able to sleep. There's a lot of songs, no? How I'm falling in love with you, I could not sleep. You know, I can't eat, so there's a lot of song. Same as like that way, you know, when we have strong attached to something or someone, we're not able to sleep, we're not able to eat. Then, cause of these two is dysfunction, the job. And then create all the problems starting from there, no? Simple, not able to sleep, then losing job, then split the family, so on and so forth. So then all the problems sort of like the creating from this kind of simple thing. So that is why I call is that the too strong attachment is a one of the poison. So it's not worth for anything. Why? Because also impermanent. Life is impermanent. Even though you get that what you wanted, but then we don't know how long you're going to use in that. Maybe you try very hard to get, and then you disappear. Then what do? You try to fight to get this, and the other people enjoying on that. So this kind of, so that is attachment. So without any attachment, it's not good, because it's, then our life became like a piece of paper. It's they need attached, because as we have this such. To important human life, but to strong attached to something also is not worth, because it is we need to remember everything is impermanent. Same at hatred, angry. So when we have the strong angry to something, someone, then again we have like not able to eat, lost appetite, not able to sleep, so on and so forth. And then also we say, you know, if you're angry too much, then your liver will destroy, you will destroy your liver. So this kind of, so the hatred is not good for many levels, especially for the physical. So we say is that our body, 75% of our body material is water. So that this water need to be is a really clean, white, pure clean water is normally managing the body. But then when we're getting angry, then looks like we're dropping ink into the water. So then our water is became little dirty. Then every day we're dropping the inks in the water, and then one day became is pure water and half, and then the dirty water. And then if we drop more and then more, so then one day it became completely dirty water. So for this kind of reason is the angry is not good for the your health, and especially like physically is not good for your heart, not good for your liver, not good for your gallbladder, and that means it's not good for all the blood circulations. So the blood is good everywhere, so in the top to the brain, toe to the toes, is not good. But it is sometimes really happened. And then the last one is that the ignorance. Ignorance means is that the you are ignorant everything. So that also is not good. Because since we get this the special human life, you ignore everything, and that causing you losing your life is quicker. An example, if we don't pay attention to your diet, people who very sort of like take good care of their body, and the people who do not take good care of their body, is the result is different. This also one ignorant result of the ignorant. Then more than that ignorant, also your ultimate sort of like goal to choose the happiness. So ignorance is not good. If we have too much ignorance, nature of the ignorance is a heavy delusion. So we can get a lot of negative depression, and then losing like the mental like memories, and then also we will get more like the heaviness problems in the body. So this kind of way they say is the three poison is very important, try to control daily by daily. So three poison control is they're not so easy, but there is a train we can train. So these three is that the, we say is the cause of the disease. So when we look in the conditions of the disease, so then we have four conditions of the disease. Your diet is one condition, behave is one condition, and the season is one condition, and the provocation is one condition. So the season and the purification is not so easy to discuss short period of time because this need a little background. But simply diet and behave, we say, always you remember these two conditions of the disease, you try to avoid it. So if you feel you have more earth element in your body, so in general, you have heavy sleep. You have like dull memory. You have less energy. You have a difficult digestion. Digestion food takes a long time. And then plus you have slightly larger body. All those signs is you have extra earth, the water element in your body. So earth and the water is like heavy, liquid, cold. So if you feel this kind of special, if you feel like difficult to digest and your digestive system is slow, and then cause of that also losing the complexion, so on and so forth, and then you try to eat less sweet product, and especially those cold nature sweet. So the cold nature sweet is like wheat product is one, potato is one. Like among the meat is like pork is one, goat product is one. So those are the sweet plus is cold nature. Any kind of sweet, cold is like the earth plus cold is heavy, no? Earth is heavy plus is like frozen is more heavier than the normal. So then this kind of is not so good. But then opposite of that, you're not able to sleep. You have 1,000 ideas constantly. Your idea is arising, but nothing able to accomplish, nothing able to apply. So what we call is not able to concentrate. You're always stressed. You always feel like short temper, aching all the joints. So this one is that your body do not have enough heavy. Your body is feel like the light. So the wind element, wind is a light, wind is a mobile. Wind is is light and mobile. So if you feel this kind of, so we have a lot of insomnia because we are living in a stressful life. Some we have, first we have study stress, then is like a job stress, then is family stress, then, you know, our stress is one top the other one. So this kind of like starting from the childhood, building those stress, like building a like a 5-floor building. So starting from the childhood, then youth age, then middle age, then, you know, building. And then result we have a not able to sleep. And then like the depression, anxiety, so this kind of. So that means is that now what happened is your wind element arises. So you don't have in your body certain like the concrete material. And especially people who do like the strong diet, this kind of. So in this case, what would be is good to drink a couple of milk, like a cup of milk, or eat something like sweet, like meat broth, something that not the sweet, like sugar cane sweet, but it is certain that the food which has the heavy quality. And then also we can choose of like a heavy, but it's warm. Warm, heavy, this kind of quality. When you're looking like the groups of the grain, is the body is, as I said before, warmer. Among the meat, it's a chicken is warm. It's not superly warm, but is lighter. Easy to digest. Fish is warm, lamb is warm, and then beef is more like neutral. So this kind of food, and then also you can make sort of like soup. And then when we're looking those like the vegetable or the fruit, apple, peach, so those kind of warm nature, because it's a little contained with the sour taste. And then also what we can do is the food we can cook, and the raw food is cook is more warmer and lighter. So we can cook food and then we can make sort of like soup. When we're cooking food also we can add in different spices. So the spicy help like the balancing the nature of the food. like a cardamom. Cardamom is the one of the warm natural spices. And then in Tibetan medicine, cardamom is one of the main medicine for stomach, the digestive system. Also, the cardamom has the power to help to calm down. So in the evening comes, you make like a light cardamom tea. It's good for help to digest food and they also calm down. Also, the cardamom is one of the medicine to calm down the all the wind element. And then nutmeg. So nutmeg also is the same, similar, but is that the different cardamom and the nutmeg is little sort of like more oil. So for that reason is nutmeg has more power to work with the wind element. So the nutmeg is good for the heart, especially like restrain the heart muscle. So that will help for the circulation of the blood. Because as the blood circulates, it's dependent with how the heart is pumping the blood, no? So if the heart muscle does not pump the blood, the blood doesn't move. So this kind of is the restrain the heart muscle. Also, the nutmeg is very good for the cholesterol, to clean the cholesterol, so to clean all the blood tube. Same time, also nutmeg is good for the brain, like memory. So what we can do is we can put the nutmeg in food when you're cooking food. Or evening you boiled a cup of milk, like half milk and a half water boiled together, and then inside you put the nutmeg. So this kind of like the drink, it became like your like how you call it, like a medicine. So the milk do have the calcium to rebuild in the calcium, because we need calcium to able to bone is the strong. Bone is the one of earth element to keep us like stable. But meantime, the milk does not have power to accumulate the mucus because it's the water, and then they boil together. On top of that the nutmeg helps to calm down the lung. So wind, and then so good for this also is good for the sleep. So in Tibet, Tibetan culture, so like a great grandparents, father, mother, children, grandchildren, we all live sort of like under one roof. Like my family, we have 4 generation, 18 family members, we live together. So, and they used to also, we have grand auntie. So at this kind of time, what we do is that every sort of like evening, we cook, we boil the milk with the water and put in nutmeg, and then small honey to help that the senior grandparents is able to sleep calmly, because we don't have the sleeping pills in the mountain. So this kind of. So this kind of, and then another one, spices also is good, ginger. So the ginger is good for if you have like difficult digesting food, you feel sort of like you don't have any appetite. This kind of time is ginger is good to make a ginger tea, and especially if you feel like a lot of mucus, like a congestion. But it's ginger is hot, but it is a little sharp. So the ginger does not have power to help for the sleeping or the calm down. So which means is ginger does not help. So the ginger is sort of like too good to clean the fat, mucus, sticky things, but the ginger does not have to calm down the wind and to make sort of like that pacifying power. So those kind of is like good for spices, warm spices to help you calm down things. So these kind of spices we can put in the soup or put in the food, and then that helps us like a medicine. In the meantime, if you have like problems with the blood, either high blood pressures. So when we look in like high blood pressure is not only one type of high blood pressure. Simply is there is two types. I'm not saying that the cause is mainly causing for the blood pressure, but is when we're putting it into the simple category, there's two categories. One blood pressure is causing from the wind element. So commonly we have that, no? Once we're stressed, our blood pressure goes up. When we are not happy, our blood pressure goes up. When we are busy, is blood pressure goes up. So those kind of blood pressure also is good to not make those food is good to calm down the blood pressure. Other than that, there's another one blood pressure is a little high, so that is that the like the quantity of the blood is a little high. So this kind of also we can put in our food, like saffron. Saffron is one of the medicine for liver. Saffron is one of the main medicine to clean the blood system and to regulate all the body temperature. If you have like high temperature, to drop down the high temperature, and especially the liver and the gallbladder, which means is also is good all the lymph systems. Also it's good to drink, either you put the saffron when you're cooking food. So the saffron does not work with like other spices, long hour cooking is does not working. But is cook in the rice or you dissolve it in the water and then drink the saffron tea is good. Another one, if you have like constipation, so this kind of like digestive problems, also like bloating, is turmeric is good. So what you can do is you put in the turmeric in the food. So the turmeric is one of the medicine to cleansing the colon. So in Tibet, in the Tibetan medicine, major colon medicine is the made based on this the turmeric. So turmeric is good. So these kind of, we can make like the different food, you observing which categories of your body, and then you think is you want to sleep more or you want to less sleep, or you want to make more appetite or less appetite, and then you can sort of like changing your diet and a simple those spices put in the food, and then that will help. So once we have this, that the our three poison able to control, so the cause is controlled, and then we will not have badly like imbalance of the bodily constituents. Once we have the more balanced bodily constituents, then we will have more healthy body. So far what I'm saying here is that the once we want to keep our body healthily or happily, happy is depend with health. If we have good health, ideally we have a happy. If we have a good happy, and then we will have a good life. And the happy, healthy also will lead to have a longer life. So these two is two very important parts. So for this reason, to keep that is based observing your body, which categories you're thinking, I have more earth element, I have more water element, I have more like fire element, and then you try to changing with those food and those spices, try to make like a daily regimen to keep your health. And then another one is that the mind. So if we have like attachment, So if you have a strong attachment, you try to like more generosity. So the antidote for the attachment is generous. So generous does not mean is now you need to give all your belonging things to people. No, that's we are not talking. Also, to become generous is we became rich, then we try to become a generous. No. Generous is a many level we can do generous. So we can teach, we can help, we can give suggestion. So anything comes with your pure intention to try to help to the sentient being, that is the generous. So simply, when we're looking, we have a lot of charities, no? Cancer charity, children charity, homeless shadows, animal shadows, so on and so forth. If we each person give a $1 a month, and then millions of people, they get millions of dollars, and they do a lot of good jobs. No? So $1 is not so difficult for us to get $1 a month to give like someone somewhere the donation. But those $1, many $1 goes to one place and they became is big dollars. But our $1, even we cannot get one cappuccino. I guess that one cup of coffee is more than $1 now. So this also one part of the generous. So the generosity comes through your intention, willing to help to the sentient being. Then antidote for the hatred is the compassion. You try to understanding is the all sentient being, same as like me, need kind loving. I like to receive people's kind, loving, respect, and why you don't like us, no? So Buddha also said, so you take your body as an example, don't harm to any other sentient beings. If you don't like sour, try don't give to sour to the other people they don't like. Because is we all like equally searching happy, healthy. If we have this ignorance, antidote for the ignorance, try to be aware of. So you try to aware of the everything. It's simply, you know. That doesn't mean now I'm aware, so became very special, like long ears, no. But is what we do is we try to is like aware of your health, aware of respect to the other people's feeling, aware of the neighbors. So this kind of is, those are the, like the antidote for the three poisons. And the last one, and then important to do the breathing, appropriate breathing. As I said before, one of the regenerating our inner element is the our through our breathing, because we constantly inhaling. What we inhaling is outer nature inhaling. So today maybe we don't have time, so I don't want to keep you here. So if you interest more like this kind of like breathing things, we have the our breathing, our yoga teacher. Tonight I did not come to here as like presenting our center and our what we doing now. I just came to simply talk for the Tibetan medicine. But since we don't have time and she's a special our yoga teacher, so we are very close to, you know, our neighbor. So come to and then to learn the how to do the exercise. There's one exercise we call the Tibetan yoga, like a yantra yoga, we call type of like yoga. So the yoga, our yoga is like the integrated the body, mind, and the breathing. So body is important, as I said before, if we don't have lubrication in the joint, we get the rheumatoid. We're not happy. If we have too much liquid here, again, swelling, we get arthritis, we are not happy. So now what we do is move, is good. Is not too much move, not too little move, is it the appropriate moving movement is good. Same, if we have too much, like hatred, ignorance, so on and so forth,
it's good to train the mind. And then special, we train this, the breathing. So through the breathing, we try to balance our inner element. So this kind of maybe is useful for you. And then also we are close to each other. So if that you interest also, you can come. And then I think every Thursday or Wednesday. Wednesday afternoon. We teaching, and then also we have other yoga teachers as well as. And then we also have Tibetan dance, and then we have Tibetan medicine. So whatever we can serve, we can help, we can benefit to the community, we are very happy. So please come to visit us. Okay? So thank you. So I stop here. If you have any question, I will check. If not, and then thank you, you are listening.
There's some questions.
Have you a list of your classes and such, or where can we get lists of like the yoga classes?
A schedule?
Uh-huh.
We have some posters for sure. Yeah. Okay. I just come back from Tibet, and then I've been a little around, so at the moment I don't know what our schedule.
Do you have it on the website?
Also we have, there's our Shung Shung, the Tibetan medicine program people, and then we have here our yoga teacher, and then we have here our community members. So you can ask them, and then they will help you. So, and then otherwise also you come see us, so for sure there's some.
There's also a sign-up list over by the food.
Yeah.
Anyone wants to sign the
name on it? Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yeah. So with the nutmeg, you were saying you have half milk, half water. If I can't drink milk, can I do it in just the water, or is that not going to give?
Yeah, water also is fine. But if you have like strong, so like heavy sleeping problems, also, you can do, or you have nerve problems, or you have mental, sort of like memory problem, you can do sort of like melt a small ghee.
Mm.
Ghee is very good. So you make it good ghee, and then 1 teaspoon of ghee you melt, and then you put like 1 tablespoon of alcohol, like a cognac. So this kind of, otherwise also it's like the one that you can do is called saki. Also saki is good. So the minimum is 1 tablespoon and a maximum 3 tablespoons.
Yeah, so for like it's how much ghee?
So the ghee is like a 1 to 2 teaspoon. And then you put, if you have like a problem of the sleep, you put in like the molasses. And then if you have like a problem of congestion or digestive system, you put in a little honey. And the honey would be the best is the raw honey.
Yep.
And then you drink that is before you go to sleep, so
with the nutmeg.
That will help.
The nutmeg.
Yeah, also you can put a little nutmeg, but otherwise no nutmeg also. Another one is then you can do sort of like, as you said, like a boiled nutmeg in the water, and then adding a little honey. Also that will help.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah.
I just wanted to thank you. I love what you're doing with the place up there.
Thank you.
You make our town a better place.
Thank you.
And I really love when last summer, I don't know, the hundreds of people from overseas that came for a weekend.
Yeah.
And I'll never, those weekend breakfasts at Baker's, the level of discussion has never been surpassed. In my case. And, so thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. The doctrine community, our community is like all over the world. So wherever our community, the local peoples are really supportive and they really liked. Because as you said, the people who have the shops and the business, they do very well. And then that thank God people who come to the our teachers, the teaching, and then they are very sort of humble. So the people like, and then they do very well business. So in Tenerife, in Spain, we have a center there, the new center. And then last time I heard that the local government tried to provide that they help us, and they try to make this like the tourist zone. Try to attract more is tourist people to come there, and then you know local people do better business. Yeah, so that's very good. Thank you. Yeah.
Thanks again so much.
Thank you.
There's lots of good food, and there's cider and coffee. Yeah. If anyone wants to stick around.
Thank you.